Hey, welcome back to the DQD, the Daily Quick Drop. Here we're carving up my son's Forerunner, bobbing the bed, as they say, taking a big section out of the canopy, and then I'll be taking a section out of the bed. Now, this piece out of the canopy is going to go up to Alaska because the guy wants to extend his canopy to fit on a long bed truck, and I'm happy to send it to him. Enjoy! So I'm using a styrene slurry technique to put the ABS back together. This is the slurry here. You just cut up a bunch of your styrene scraps and add this plastic weld stuff here to it. And it turns into a liquid plastic that dries like solid rock that you can sand and smooth out. So try and keep the lid on there. If it just gets hard and it doesn't run anymore, just add a little more of that good stuff right there. Just don't breathe a lot of it in because I'm pretty sure it can cause something bad inside you. Yeah, so let's do a little bit together. Oh, I cut an inch out of this topper and now I'm rejoining it because we're gonna shorten up the bob this Forerunner. This is a build for my son and he wants kind of a junkyard build, and so I'm not too worried about being making it perfect, but I still want it to look like it's legit, right? So I started, cut the inch out, and then I glued, super glued, these two ends on here to kind of give it some stability, and put some tape on here to give this part right here some stability. It's already pretty well dry, so there's nothing on my fingers, and I just applied that. So now I'm going to go ahead and apply the rest of it all the way across. I can take my tape off now, and I start by laying in this stuff here first, and I want to get that down into the crack, and I'll just go through and kind of prime it, if you will, but I want the real thin stuff to seep all the way down in the crack, okay, just like that. And that's all we need there. Now, when you're working with the styrene slurry, it dries really fast. So grab yourself a giant toothpick or something to apply it. And you kind of get it out there and just kind of lay it down right in that groove there. And I kind of twist it almost like it's a plastic weld. And try and push it into the joint and fill in all the holes. And you can see that it's already starting to dry. And your working time is like a minute and a half or 2 minutes, and then you're done. And just to clean the toothpick off, grab yourself a piece of paper towel and just wipe it clean. And we'll get just another little helping on here. And it's a little stringy, that's okay. But it works really, really well. And so what I like about it is that you can actually sand it. And it is technically is melting, you know, the ABS together. And yeah, now that's not super pretty, but I'll tell you what, it's going to hold up if it rolls over. And we'll go ahead and treat the other side too. But you can see right there, I'm getting it pushed into that joint. And that's really what I'm trying to do. So, all right, I'm going to continue to work off camera here, and we'll show you some progress here in a bit.